Philadelphia Zoo, oldest in the country, tries an experiment in its new birdhouse. It's opened its cages so that birds and humans can mingle without the interference of wire, glass, or netting. The birds seem to like it. As for the humans, they can stare at a South American lapwing just as if they were alone with it in the jungle. And the cock of the rock doesn't mind visitors at all. A golden-fronted bulbul is perfectly at home on a familiar azalea bush. And any bird is free to supervise from a perch on the cameraman's shoulders as he photographs a flock of Victoria crowned pigeons from New Guinea, largest pigeons in the world. This pair of rare Indian hornbills, who have a 7-foot wing spread, resemble the Brazilian toucans with their 8-inch beaks. Another of the 51 exotic species who mingle with tourists and sightseers is the motmot, common to Central America. One of the favorites is the American hummingbird, whose freewheeling maneuvering skill as he hovers over the aviary pond surpasses that of a helicopter. Shorebirds, among them black-necked stilts and European oyster catchers, live in an authentic background of sand and driftwood.
I'm tired. I've been on my feet all day.